Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the Orchis Yosher. We're in the holding by Shir number 60, moving along in the Sefer very nicely, as we have begun the Midah, the trait of Zrizus alacrity. And the Rav Chaim Kanievsky continues with the following statements from the words of our sages. And it says, La'olam yakdim adam dvar mitzvah, a person should always be first to do a mitzvah. How do we know that? Shebishvil laila echad shekadmasa bichir letzira. Because if you remember the story of Lot and his daughters, they ran up to the cave and the daughters thought that they were the only three people left in the entire world. And they decided that it was a mitzvah for them to lie carnally with their father, that they should have children so they could populate the world, because Hashem wants a world where there's population, where there's people. So what happened over there? The older daughter took the reins first, and she lay with her father before the younger one. And she took that upon herself with Zrizus. Says the Gemara over there, Zachsa v'kadmasa arba daris b'Yisrael. And as a result of that, she ended up having four generations of the great leaders before her younger sister. And from her is Mayav, and from Mayav comes Rus. We know the famous story of Rus by Shavuos, and eventually from Rus comes David HaMelech, King David, and from King David is going to come Mashiach. So because that a person does their mitzvahs bezrizus, even over here, where it looked like it was the wrong thing, but they did it what's called the Shem Shemaim for the sake of heaven, therefore she was rewarded. U'mibrachais, and the Gemara it says further, La'olam yarutz adam l'dvar mitzvah. A person should always run to perform a mitzvah. Even on Shabbos, when we know that a person is supposed to walk differently on Shabbos, calm, at ease, peacefully, we don't normally run. But when it comes to a mitzvah, even on Shabbos, a person should run. And it says over there as well, Le'me'al mitzvah le'mirhat. When you're leaving a Beis HaKnesses, a sanctuary, you're not supposed to take long strides. You have to show that it's hard for you to leave the sanctuary. It's hard to leave the Beis HaKnesses, the shul. You're leaving the world of prayer, the world of learning, the world of Kiddusha, and you have to go back into the world at large. However, when it comes to going into the Beis HaKnesses, when you're heading towards the shul, over there, a person has a mitzvah to run. You can't wait to get to that place where you're going to be able to commune and speak to Hashem, where you'll be able to learn His Torah, where you'll have the four walls and the roof to protect you from all of the elements of the outside world. For that mitzvah, you're going to run. And it says further, Shiva kemenudin l'shamayim. There are seven types of people that are considered to be like banished by Hashem. The echad man, and one of them is Misha'ein Ratz L'dvar Mitzvah, someone who doesn't run to perform a mitzvah. Could you imagine, whatever the other six people are on that list, they're much worse than the person who doesn't run for a mitzvah. But a person who doesn't run for a mitzvah shows that the mitzvah is not important to him. And if the mitzvah is not important to him, that means that the one who's commanding us to do the mitzvah must not be important to us. And that's Hashem. And therefore, someone who doesn't take the mitzvahs with zrizus, with alacrity, doesn't get enthusiastic, doesn't run to do them, it's actually showing that there's a disconnect between them and the Ribbono Shel Olam. U'b'midbar Rabba, and finally, today we'll conclude, Hein am kelavi yakum ka'ar yisnasa. This was just a verse that we had in Parshas Balak, where Bilam opens his mouth to curse the Jewish people, but instead the bracha of, Behold, the people will arise like a lion cub and raise itself like a lion. Ayimdim b'mitasan, then the Gemara expounds, Ayimdim b'mitasan ka'arayos, ka'ayaros. They wake up from their bed, they arise from their bed energetically like lions. Chaitfim kriyashima, and they recite, and they seize, they grab the mitzvah of Kriya Shema to be able to recite it. So that's why a person is supposed to wake up like a lion in the morning. When a lion finally wakes up after all of his hours of sleep, he wakes up with great zest and alacrity. And here for the Jewish people, what do? We grab the mitzvahs as soon as we possibly can. Wishing everybody a wonderful day in which you see through your own zerizos, your own alacrity and zealousness for the sake of mitzvahs, HaKadosh Baruch Hu puts many, many opportunities to grab the mitzvahs that are in front of you. Have a wonderful day.